off it comes to Trent. In the corner to Anfernee for three. Got it. Man, what a poised young man shooting the lights out from three.
Welcome to the Anfernee Simons Player Review here on Blazers Uprise. I'm your host, Tori Jones, and this is the second out of 15 player reviews. If you haven't seen the one on Gary Trent Jr. that dropped an hour ago, make sure to go check it out. We're starting off with the rookies, and the second rookie up is Simons, who had a little bit more of a promising rookie year than I honestly expected. This dude has some talent and has some skill, and you could see his improvement throughout the season, the little bit of spot minutes that he got, and it culminated in that amazing game in the final game of the regular season when he dropped 37 points on the Sacramento Kings. What I noticed in that game was he played with a lot of poise that really impressed me. Coming out of a guy that never even played college basketball. He was running the offense effectively as a point guard, was pretty much always in control, never forced, played at his own pace, and for a 19-year-old kid, that's very, very impressive. And it's especially promising when you consider his combination of shooting skill, ball handling ability, ability to finish at the rim, and his athleticism. Most of the time when you have a guard that is able to be that poised in his rookie season, you're talking about a guy who doesn't have any of those traits. You're talking about a TJ McConnell, you know, maybe a guy that can defend and run the offense a little bit, but he's not going to have upside like Anfernee Simons does. And most of the time, those are multi-year college players, not a guy who never saw a college floor. So the improvements in his poise that he showed throughout the season has me very, very excited. And I know that Kings game is only one game, but I do believe you can take things out of that game and notice where he's improved in areas like his poise. Some of the passes he also made in that game, I didn't know he actually had the vision to see. When he got drafted, he was labeled as a combo scoring guard, but the way he was running the offense in that final game of the season and some of the passes he made have me excited for his potential as a lead guard off the bench going forward, because this dude is far ahead of where I expected him to be in terms of his ability to run an offense and his ability to make some passes. On the opposite side of that, he didn't really shoot well in the limited time he saw throughout the season. Now, he only had two games where he played meaningful minutes leading up to that final game, so you can't really base it off of that. But I was slightly worried because his shot looked flat, his shot looked like it was hitting the rim hard, and although it was close to going in, when you hit the rim that hard with a flat shot, it's hard to consistently knock down shots. And that was up until the final game of the regular season where he knocked down 7 threes and his shot looked fine. And that just showed me that his struggles with his shot throughout the season was just due to barely playing. Because once he finally got comfortable on an NBA court, he was tearing nets up. He was putting the rip in Rip City. And I know a lot of this is just based off that final game, but I didn't expect Anfernee Simons to be capable of putting up a game like that at the end of his rookie season. He did have a couple flashes before that final game where he impressed me with his body control, with his quickness, but being able to remain under control. And those are things that have me excited for him going forward as well. But now he needs to work his butt off this summer, because there's a very good chance that he'll be in the rotation next season. Portland is set to lose Seth Curry, and Anfernee Simons is being dubbed as the guy to replace him. So now looking at what Anfernee Simons needs to work on this summer, first off, he needs to get his butt in the weight room and add some strength, because he's still a pretty skinny kid, and defensively, he's often overpowered by opposing guards, because he doesn't have the strength to really hold his ground. Added strength will also help him offensively, as he'll be able to put his shoulder and put his body into opposing defenders, knock them off balance, and he'll be able to create some space that way. He already does this a little bit. He's had some moves in the past year where he's put his body into an opposing defender and actually knocked them off balance a little bit, and it made him seem a little bit stronger than I think he actually is. Now, just imagine if he added some real strength to some of the moves he's able to make, because he's already pretty good at knowing where to put his shoulder in the defender's chest, knowing when to create contact with the defender to knock them off balance. The second thing he needs to work on is his shooting, because he needs to be able to consistently knock down threes off the bench to help Portland out. That's what Seth Curry excelled at, and we can't have a drop-off from a 45% three-point shooter to a 34% three-point shooter. Anthony Simons next year, in my opinion, is going to need to be a 37% three-point shooter or better, and I think he has the potential. I'm just concerned that he doesn't have the consistency. So in order to get that consistency, he needs to get his shots up this summer, 1,000 shots per day, and be able to get himself to the point where he's able to shoot 37% from the three-point line. And then, as pretty much any guard should always do every single summer, he needs to continue to refine his skills. His ball handling ability is already pretty good, but he needs to work on more game-specific situations where he can use his dribble to create shots for himself and others. He also needs to continue to work on his passing. This he can also do in game-specific drills and by simply playing in live action and by making it an area of focus for him. Going into Summer League, he needs to try and be an all-around dynamic point guard in terms of scoring the ball, but also creating for others and seeing passes that are there. Working on different types of passes is also key. One-handed passes off the dribble, skip passes, leading a backdoor cutter. He needs to work on every game-specific scenario where he might throw a pass because he's going to need to be able to be our main creator off the bench. Right now, that role is occupied by Evan Turner, and I think Anthony Simons can definitely take it from him if he works hard this summer. So to summarize Anthony Simons' season, there wasn't much, but that last game of the year has me very, very excited for his future. I'm very excited to watch him in Summer League, and I think he's going to be a blast to watch. Now he just needs to make that second year leap, much like De'Aaron Fox did last year for the Sacramento Kings. So anyway, leave your comments down in the comment section below and let me know what you think of Anthony Simons. What did you think about his rookie year? What do you hope to see out of him in Summer League? And what role do you think he'll play next season? So anyway, that's a wrap for the Anthony Simons player review. This has been Tori. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Peace out. Go Blazers.